Hi, and welcome to 5 Questions with Fidelity. I'm Susie Allen, joined by Chris Sheldon, Chief Investment Officer with Fidelity Personal and Workplace Advisors. Chris, welcome, and thanks for joining me.
Thanks. It's great to be here.
So we at Fidelity have talked a lot about the markets and stocks and bonds this past year. Given how difficult last year was for both stocks and bonds, we felt that we should broaden the conversation to include alternative investments. So Chris, why do you think they are so important right now?
It's nice that stocks and bonds have recovered somewhat, but the challenging environment of the last year created an opportunity for people to look beyond the traditional 60-40 portfolio. By that I mean 60% stocks, 40% bonds, which I think is a really good thing. By considering alternative investments, investors can add a broad array of investment opportunities that may not all be available in more traditional stock and bond categories. While the potential contribution of any of them will vary, the benefits can range from the potential to enhance returns, help to diversify a portfolio, which can improve the risk-return trade-offs, increase opportunities for income, or provide some degree of inflation protection.
Inflation protection on the minds of clients right now. So it seems like alternative investments might mean different things to different people. So let's get a definition here. What are alternative investments?
The category is incredibly broad. Historically, it has often been a catch-all for investments that didn't fit neatly into traditional categories of stocks, bonds, or short-term investments. As interest and investment in the area has grown, common definitions have become more established and differentiated. Alternative investments can include investments in the equity or debt of private companies, lending directly to private companies, inflation protection-oriented strategies such as real estate, natural resources, or infrastructure investments. So you can't just say, I want to own alternatives.
Given that it's such a big category, how do I know if alternative investments and which types are right for me?
You have to have an idea of what you're trying to achieve by adding them to your portfolio. Your specific goals and preferences help inform which alternative investments might make sense to consider. There is no one-size-fits-all. The combination or bundle an investor might own is very personalized to their situation. That said, some investors might benefit from including alternative investments in their portfolios. Just as an example, a client looking for some protection on rising rates might consider adding private credit. Or a client looking for inflation protection might consider adding real asset strategies to a portfolio. A client looking to diversify a portfolio of public equities might add a private equity investment.
All right, well, that cues up our next question perfectly. What are some of the potential benefits of these types of investments?
I see several primary benefits. The first is gaining access to investment areas that are not typically offered by traditional asset classes. Another benefit is that they can act differently than a portfolio consisting of only publicly traded stocks and bonds. This diversification may improve the risk-return trade-offs in a portfolio by adding assets that perform differently at different times. An investment that may retain value when others decline can be very helpful for long-term asset allocation and for helping you ultimately reach your financial goals.
All right, reaching financial goals, super important. So what are some of the considerations?
While some alternative investments have liquidity, others do not. What I mean by liquidity is that someone could get out of them quickly, while others have extended periods where the money is committed before the funds might be available for use. Examples of liquid alternatives might include some commodity funds, event-driven or relative value funds, which focus on corporate events like mergers and acquisitions. They are generally more liquid and often pursue unique strategies compared to traditional mutual funds. Historically, illiquidity has often offered a higher return, in part to help compensate for the lack of immediate access to the funds.
All right, what else should investors be thinking about?
An investor needs to consider their time frame and make sure they understand the potential liquidity implications for each investment. If funds are needed for a goal that may be less than the expected time frame of the investment, certain illiquid investments may not be appropriate. Also, there are often unique tax considerations in reporting for some illiquid alternative investments. There are also certain eligibility criteria that investors must meet to purchase certain alternative investments. As always, investors should understand risks and consider the fees of any potential investment.
If someone's interested in an alternative investments opportunity, what's the next step?
Because of the complexity of alternatives, potential investors should consider talking to a professional to help them understand the various possible investments that might be appropriate and other aspects they should consider. For clients in our managed account portfolios, many of them do include alternatives as part of their efforts to reduce the overall risk of the portfolio and help smooth out returns for investors.
Awesome, Chris. Thanks so much for joining me today.
It's been my pleasure to be here.
For more timely news and thinking from Fidelity's top thought leaders, subscribe to Insights from Fidelity Wealth Management. I'm Susie Allen. Please join me again soon.